Hello. Hello. The hunter returns from the hills.
Hmm? I'd say the hunter is very well oiled.
Hmm?
You had a liquid lunch, have you?
Oh, yes, we had some wine and a few liqueurs.
Made quite an afternoon of it.
Yes, we were there for most of the afternoon, I come to think of it.
We?
Yes, me and a client.
Oh, that Swedish girl.
Yes, Anna.
You two seem to be getting along very well.
Well, I told you, she's a very important client.
Would you like to bring her home to dinner one night?
Oh, no, darling, I don't want to bore you with all that business chatter.
Well, you've brought other clients home, I haven't minded. Or would Anna rather go to a restaurant?
She certainly enjoys high living, I tell you that.
Does she? Yeah.
Oh, that's Hannah, the one on the right. We had her taken at a restaurant. She wanted a fellow to take home with her. It must have got mixed up with some papers I was showing.
Oh, then you do discuss some business, do you?
Gaffney. Gaffney?
You get a stretcher from the examination room and bring it to Gaffney's cell straight away.
Why? She's sick.
Just do as you're told. And if you see Miss Bennett on the way through, tell her I want to see her straight away.
Darling, I don't know why you've gone quiet on me. I admit I didn't make a big thing about her looks.
Why not?
Because she's not my type, that's why. I didn't think you'd be jealous.
I'm not. Just can't understand why you lied to me.
I didn't lie, darling. I just omitted to tell the truth. No. What would you want me to do? Come home and say, I've just had lunch with a ravishing, gorgeous, Swedish blonde?
No, I would have been jealous, but I wouldn't have been suspicious.
All right. Total honesty. I cannot tell a lie. Anna is deeply in love with me, and I'm cruelly manipulating her to get the contract.
That sounds more like the Bob Morris I know.
Seriously, darling, contract is very important, both in money and prestige.
Yes, I know, darling. Take no notice of me. I've just been silly.
No, you're not, darling. I realise I spent a lot of time with Hannah recently. Now, look, why don't you join us for lunch tomorrow?
Me? Tomorrow? Oh, no, no, I couldn't.
Yes, you could. 12:30, L'Endroit Vert. Be there.
You know, I should have realised that Nick would only see it from a teenager's point of view.
What's it got to do with him?
Oh, nothing, nothing. It was just something he said about Anna coming into the office.
What have you been saying?
Oh, darling, it doesn't matter. I probably took it the wrong way. Forget it.
Yeah, you wait till I see him.
No, Bob, please.
Hey, darling, it's all right. I'm not going to send him packing. But he's got to realise that our private life is our own. I won't have him interfering and causing trouble between
us. I'm sure he didn't mean to.
Well, I hope not.
Any idea who did it?
No, it could have been anybody.
She certainly made herself unpopular enough.
I don't suppose you two can tell me anything about this.
Honest, Mr. Fletch, we wouldn't have a clue.
Yeah, all right. Go to the rec room and stay there. No one's to leave until I say so. I suppose Mr. Franklin's left.
Yes, about half an hour ago.
Yeah, well, I better call the doctor in. She could have a fractured skull, concussion or anything. Look, clean her up a bit, will you?
Yes.
I'd better tell Mrs. Davidson. Hope she hasn't left yet.
You know, I reckon Davo's pretty thinking about this needs committee.
Yeah, well, she might be, but I think the screws are trying to muck it up.
Well, she's really keen for us to have a go. Well, she wasn't. I'd still be at Barnhurst. We'll give a 10 out of 10 for trying. Up until now, it's been the screws that have run this place.
Oh, really? I thought you ran it.
Hey, Doreen, where have you been?
Just a little bloody loo, do you mind?
Well, how about that? Now, was I being nosy?
Oh, you know what she's like.
Well, I still think we should give this needs committee thing a go.
What, are you on commission or something?
No, but if they're offering something, what have we got to lose?
Oh, sorry, Mr. Harrison, but Mr. Fletcher said we had to come here and tell everyone to stay here till he said we could go. Margo's been bashed.
Right, I'll look after this lot. You bring the women from the library. Come on inside.
Here was the drum.
She was out cold in her cell, B. Angie and I had to take her to the infirmary.
Do you know anything?
Oh, no, B, honest.
Well, just as well I was in here with a screw watching me the whole time. Fletch will have to find someone else to pin this one on.
Yeah, it could be anybody.
Yeah. Even a screw.
Yes, Wentworth. Could you ask him to come straight away, please? Thank you.
Shall I call an ambulance?
No, let's see what the doctor has to say first. Right. Who do you think could have done it?
Well, Smith is the obvious suspect.
Too obvious. Anyway, by now, she's probably got a watertight alibi. Mm. I take it you haven't checked the others' whereabouts?
No, I haven't had time, really.
Have the women been returned to their cells?
No.
Jim, you do think it was one of the prisoners, don't you?
Well, yes, of course. Who else could it be?
Well, I suppose we'd better see if Gaffney can throw any light on the matter.
Ow!
Lie still, Gaffney.
Oh, what am I doing in here? What happened?
You were found unconscious in your cell. Who hit you?
God, what did they use? A sledgehammer?
Who?
Oh, I don't know. Got hit from behind, remember?
You've got no idea who it could have been?
Yeah, I bloody have. It was your bloody boyfriend.
Watch it, Gaffney.
It was bloody Terry Harrison, I tell you. He was after the evidence.
What evidence? I'm warning you, Gaffney. If you're accusing an officer...
I ought to know you'd try and cover up for him. Do a good bloody snow job, won't you?
I've got no intention of covering up for any officer. Now, if you've got proof...
Oh, I've got proof, all right. Your boyfriend's a bent screw. He brought in a bottle of grog for me. You go and have a look in my cupboard. You'll find a bundle of paperbacks tied up with string. Open them up, and you'll find a bottle of scotch and a tape.
No, you must have concussion.
Go on, Vera. Go and have a look. I'd like to see your face when you hear what's on that tape.
Gaffney.
God, I need a bloody smoke.
Keep a civil tongue in your head.
Are you feeling all right?
Oh, yeah. Half my head's missing, but I'll live.
Can you tell us what happened?
Yeah, I was just telling Miss Bennett just now. It was that mongrel Harrison. He tried to set me up. Brought in a bottle of grog for me.
I presume you can prove these accusations.
You betcha. Yeah. Got every little word on tape. Miss Bennett's going to get the cassette now.
There was nothing there, Gaffney.
What?
There was a bundle of paperbacks in her cupboard. The middle had been cut out for a hiding place, but it was empty.
Of course. Stands to reason, doesn't it? That's why he bashed me, so he could search the cell without me yelling blue murder. He's got him.
Rubbish. I was a fool to believe you in the first place.
There will be a doctor here soon to examine you. I'll talk to you later. In the meantime, you are not to discuss this with anyone. Do you understand? Do you understand?
Oh, yeah.
Do you think her story is possible, Miss Bennett?
Of course I don't. Mr. Harrison is far too good an officer to do such a thing. Surely you don't believe her?
I'm interested in any explanation of the incident. It wouldn't be the first time a member of staff has broken the regulations. What do you think, Mr. Fletcher?
I think we'd find out more if we questioned the other women.
Yes, it's nearly dinner time. Well, let them have their meal and then return them all to the recreation room. I'll speak to them individually afterwards.
We should make them go without dinner.
An empty stomach won't make them any more helpful, Miss Bennett.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson, you should know. I caught B. Smith threatening Gaffney this afternoon.
That doesn't surprise me. There's hardly anything happens in this prison without Smith being involved. I shall be in my office, Mr. Fletcher.
You seem pretty certain that Terry didn't do it.
Of course he didn't do it. I mean, you don't believe Gaffney's lies.
I don't know. I just hope that you're keeping your personal feelings out of this.
Can I have the salt, please? Terrific meal.
Thanks.
Well, tomorrow's the big day. The signatures go on the contract in the morning and we'll be official Australian agents for Jova Furniture.
Will that mean a lot more work for you?
Not initially. I've got to see Arthur about the marketing and there'll be a few interstate trips to set up retail outlets.
Anna be going?
No. Now she's leaving all that to me. As a matter of fact, she's leaving for Hong Kong tomorrow evening.
Business or pleasure?
A bit of both, actually. By the way, darling, I've promised to take her to the airport, so I'll be late home.
Yes, well, I'll be late too. I'll fix us up something quick for dinner.
I can do it.
No, it's all right.
You said I've got to do my share around the house. It's no problem.
Well, you must admit you haven't tried his cooking. He may be better than you.
All right then, Nick. Thank you.
All right, Cavelli, you can go.
Next.
Oh, lucky last.
Be quiet, Smith.
I want to know what happened to Gaffney.
So do I.
Who did it, Smith?
Well, it wasn't me. Scouts are. You can ask Officer Knox if you like. I was in the recreation room the whole time.
I believe someone else did it at your instigation.
Have you ever considered it just might not be one of us for a change?
You are suggesting it was a member of staff. Do you have any proof?
No, but I've got my suspicions.
So have I. And they lie strongly in your direction.
Oh, please yourself. But if I can't get anything out of the women, you've got Buckley's.
I am determined to wipe out this kind of violence, Smith.
Well, in that case, you better start recruiting your screws from the Salvation Army and quit blaming us for everything that goes wrong in
Smith.
Here.
It's all right, Miss Bennett. Very well, Smith, you can go, but don't think you've heard the end of this.
Officer Knox. Mrs. Davidson, are you going to call in the police?
I don't think so. We can't be sure that Mr. Harrison is not involved. On the other hand, if he is, well, the department prefers to keep his own house in order. You'd better keep Gaffney in the hospital overnight. I know the doctor said she was fit, but we can't allow her to go back with the other prisoners. I'll speak to Mr. Harrison in the morning.
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
Jim, how's Gaffney?
Well, the doc pronounced her fit. It'll take more than a bump on the head to crack that particular skull.
Any leads on the basher?
No, I was hoping you could tell me that.
No, not a thing. A list of Gaffney's enemies would read like a muster sheet.
Yeah, there'd be quite a few people anxious to get at it, wouldn't there?
Not too right. Like when I found her in her cell after Smith's mob had been at her.
Yes, I had thought of that. You sure it was Smith?
Oh, yeah, it was Smith. Oh, no, wait a minute. You don't think I had anything to do with it?
Well, Gaffney did mention it. Something about a bottle of scotch and a tape. Vera searched the cell for it, but she said it was missing.
Tape? What tape?
A recording she claims to have made of you offering to smuggle in some grog for her.
Oh, no, come on, that's a heap of crap. Look, Jim, she's trying to frame me. Just because I said her information wasn't worth a cracker.
What'd you buy your information with, Terry?
Oh, look, Jim, all I did was put up a few bets on the outside for her. You know, turned a blind eye, the sort of thing we discussed, you know, gain their confidence. Look, I wouldn't risk trafficking.
Good. I just have to hear you say it.
Oh, no, Jim, we go back a long way. I'm surprised you even thought it.
Yeah, I'm sorry, mate, but I had to mention it.
Vera, did you find anything in Gaffney's cell?
What?
Well, the scotch, the tapes. Did she tell you where she hid it?
Well, then they do exist.
Yeah, look, I thought you might have found it and covering up for me.
No.
Bloody hell. Well, she hasn't got it. Who has?
Oh, no. I've seen that movie once. I've seen it a dozen times. Oh, that's my cue for bed. Bob?
Oh, sorry, darling. I was just running the sales figures through my head.
She says I can't leave my work at the office. I'm going to bed.
I'll be here shortly.
Oh, after you fixed up your trial balance?
Yeah. Good night.
No, no. Night, Nick.
Night.
Well, how's it all going, Nick? Oh, the job and everything.
Fine. I mean, as long as you're happy.
Oh, I have no complaints. You seem to be doing quite well at the job and, well, I'm quite happy for you to be staying here.
But what?
Well, I'd rather you didn't interfere in our personal lives, Meg's and mine.
What do you mean?
Look, Nick, I'm sure I don't have to spell it out to you. Meg and I have a very honest and open relationship.
You mean I muck things up for you by telling her about the Swedish bird? You are making a bloody good contact there.
There was absolutely nothing to tell. Anna was just a very important business contact. Meg knows that. I told her. And I'm telling you now, Nick, either you stop trying to cause trouble between us or you can find somewhere else to live. Now, what's it to be?
Fair enough. I'll be more careful from now on.
Hi, Bill.
Hi.
How's the hangover?
Don't ask.
What was all that about?
Oh, he told me yesterday he had to go to a bucks night. A mate of his got married for the third time. I think they'd learn after a while, wouldn't you?
I don't know what you're so happy about with the trouble you're in.
Well, I don't want to burden everybody with my problems. It'll work out.
At least you now know why I tried to warn you. You can't make deals with the scum in here. There's certainly no such thing as honour among thieves
all
in
right,
Wentworth.
All right, you made your point. Once bitten, twice shy. I just didn't want you to get mixed up in it.
Look, Terry, I know these women better than you, and I know what they're capable of doing. I'm not going to have any of them hold anything over an officer. It affects discipline all round.
Yeah. I don't think we'll find anything now, anyway.
Oh, yes, we will. B. Smith and her cronies are at the bottom of this, and they won't be able to resist telling us. If we keep our eyes open, we'll find out who's got the tape and the scotch.
All right.
Hey, one way we can find out who the thief is. See who's got a hangover. Hey, maybe it's Bill.
Well, I'm at a loss. There isn't one prisoner who can't prove her whereabouts at the time Gaffney was bashed.
Well, there's still Burns and Trapp.
Well, Doreen says she was in the toilet, and Mrs. Hill confirms there was someone in the cubicle. As for Heather Trapp, well, can you see her attacking someone like Gaffney? The poor girl's afraid of her own shadow most of the time.
Yes, well, I hate to say it, Mrs. Davidson, but could it be a member of staff?
Well, it is a possibility, however distasteful.
Do you want to call on the police?
I'd prefer to deal with the matter internally, but a crime has been committed.
Well, on the other hand, the police probably won't be able to dig up any more information than we can. We do know the women better than they do.
I want this matter cleared up.
Well, so do I. It seems a pity to waste police time on what could possibly turn out to be just a squabble between prisoners.
Yes, very well. In any case, we can't allow Gaffney to go back with the other women. A transfer's out of the question at the moment, so isolation is the only alternative.
Right. I'll arrange it for you. I think you've made the right decision, Mrs. Davidson.
I hope so.
Morning, Gaffney.
What do you want? Come back to finish the job, have you?
I don't think I'm stupid enough to hit you, do you? I'm in enough trouble with that tape recording you made.
Don't come the raw prawn. You took the tape and the scotch after you bashed me.
Oh, I didn't bash you. Somebody did, though.
There you go, then. Someone's running around the prison with enough evidence to get you kicked out for good. You can't trust anyone these days, can you?
Who was it, Gaffney?
You want to know? You go find out.
Well, you must have some idea. How's your head?
What's it to you?
Well, if you're okay, I'll put you back in with the other women. One of them might want another go at you.
You threatening me?
I mean, you can't stay here forever, can you?
I can look after myself.
What's going on?
He's threatening me, Mr. Fletcher.
You're taking a bit of a risk, aren't you, being alone with her after her accusation?
I got nothing to hide.
Yeah, maybe not. But at times like these, it pays to have a witness around. You make sure you've got an officer with you when you're with Gaffney in future. And as for you, Gaffney, you can forget about trying to set up an officer. You'll get nowhere without any proof. Get your dressing gown on.
Why?
Because you're being transferred to the isolation wing.
What? If you want to get rid of me, why don't you send me to Barnhurst?
Just do as you're told. You can come with me. I'm taking no chances with that one.
Here, love. We'll work for you.
Oh, hokey spidokey, Judy, baby.
She's a happy little Vegemite today. What got into her?
Oh, I don't know. I think the nurse gave her some pills for her gastro. It must have set her high.
How come she's working if she's crook?
Beats me.
Oh, terrific. Listen, any word on who bashed Margo?
No.
How about you lot? Any word from the other blocks?
Well, if any of the women did it be, they keep them quiet about it.
Well, you spread the word. It's me that wants to know, not one of the screws. So whoever did it's got to come and tell me.
What are you going to do? Give them a medal?
Yeah, something like that. Chances are whoever bashed Margo also took her grog. I don't want them staggering around blind drunk giving the game away, do
I? Maybe Terry took it back.
Well, then why give it to her in the first place?
Well, maybe she wouldn't come across.
I don't believe that story for a minute. She's got to be lagging for him.
What are you up to?
Well, actually, Vera, I reckon we might dash down to the pub for lunch. You want to join us?
Yeah, I'm desperate for a scotch and soda.
Make mine a scotch on the rocks. I'll be watching you very carefully, Smith. Don't you always, Vera?
Well, I must admit it's years since I've been skiing, but I used to be quite good.
When you come to Sweden, we will go, you and I.
Well, I was rather hoping that my next European holiday would be in summer.
Oh, this is good. We can go sailing. Have you sailed in Stockholm?
No, never.
There we will go. Stockholm is beautiful, always. It is
Mr. Morris's table, he's expecting me.
Would you come this way, please? Hello, darling.
Sorry I'm late.
That's all right. Darling, this is Anna Johansson. Anna, my wife, Meg.
I'm so pleased to meet you. Bob has been talking about you.
Oh, good, I hope.
Two more of the same and a martini, please. And could we have the menu? Thanks.
Thank you. How do you like Australia?
Oh, the little bit I see, I like. Bob has been very kind and shows me around. Do you think perhaps he's not been home much lately? I'm sorry.
We both keep pretty busy.
Look, I hate to hurry things along, but I have an appointment with an advertising agency this afternoon, so would you mind if we would?
Yeah.
Well, I'm so hungry I'd even eat Wentworth food.
You may have those
meals. Well, I'm pretty hungry too.
You'd be careful what you eat with that tummy wog, Doreen.
Would you care to join us for an aperitif before lunch?
Oh, an aperitif. How nice.
Hey, Doreen, are you sure you're all right? Because if you're not feeling up to it, you might as well take the rest of the day off.
I told you, I'm fine.
Oh, damn.
What's wrong with you?
That bloody thief is at it again. All my cassettes are gone.
All of them?
Yes, every one.
Well, then it can't have been Margo, then. You know, something very fishy is going on here. First of all, we've got a cell thief and someone who's bashed Margo and isn't letting on. And when I find out who it is, they're going to have some fast explaining to do.
Coffee?
Oh, yeah, black, please.
Two white, one black.
Meg, if Bob has urgent business this afternoon, we could go shopping together, perhaps.
Oh, I'd love to, but unfortunately, I work too.
Oh, I'm sorry, Bob did not mention this.
I sometimes think Bob isn't too proud of my line of work.
Hey, that's not fair.
Why, what do you do?
Meg's a probationer and a parole officer at a women's prison here.
Really? You should not be unproud of her for that.
I'm not.
I am most interested in prison reform. My brother is a civil servant in Swedish prison, and my father has a scheme at the factory to employ prisoners.
Uh-huh. A kindred spirit.
I refuse to take part in this conversation.
Oh, take no notice, Meg. Men are such children. I would love to know about Australian prison. Do you see inside them much?
Oh, yes. I was a prison officer for several years before I started welfare work.
Better and better. Tell me, what is the attitude to Australian prisoners? Is it to punish or make good for society?
Well, of course, we do try to make good. But unfortunately, the system here hasn't really kept up with the times.
Yeah. In Sweden, we have very modern prisons. And in Denmark, a prison for men and women together. Yeah, we to work toward this.
Oh, I think the system here in Australia has a long way to go before that happens here.
I would love to see inside a prison.
Well, you could arrange that, couldn't you, Meg?
Oh, could you?
Well, I don't know, darling. I'd have to get departmental approval.
Well, I'm sure Erica would agree if you explained the position.
Well, I suppose.
Please, if you could.
And it will certainly solve my problem with how to keep Anna entertained this afternoon.
Well, I can't promise anything. It really does depend on Erica.
With a good Swedish name like that, she will say yes.
Good, then it's all settled. I'll see you back at the office about 4:30. We can take a final look at the contracts and then I'll run you out to the airport.
I reckon the tucker in here is getting worse. Hey, Doreen, how's your tummy wog?
Oh, not bad.
Listen, are you sick or not?
Of course I am. I have to keep running to the loo, don't I?
Well, that's what you tell us, but you seem chirpy enough to me.
Well, there's no point in being sour just because you're crook, you know.
Hey, have a look at this. Yours?
Yeah. I got back from lunch, they're sitting in my cell, large as life. And what's more, they've been plagued because some of them are half wound on.
Well, it seems our cell thief is playing funny buggers. And it can't be any of the women because we were all at lunch together. So we know who that leaves, don't we?
Oh, here I go again.
One of the screws.
Yeah. Mr. Harrison by name. And Margo told me she had him on tape agreeing to bring some grog in for her. My bet is she's hidden it and he's trying like mad to find it.
Well, you don't think he bashed her to get at them, do you?
What do you reckon? Obviously, Margo hid it too well. Hey, Hazel. You're on trolley duty this arvo. Spread the word. There's a cassette missing with a very interesting conversation on it. And I want it. And when we find it, we're going to have a bit of fun with Mr. Terry Harrison.
Hello?
Collect the dirty plates, Dobbs, and no talking.
Time to gloat, have you, Vera?
Shut up, Gaffney. You brought it all on yourself.
Yeah. Should have known better than to trust a screw. You know, if you'd have kept your word and got me that ticket to Barnhurst, all this would never have happened.
As far as I'm concerned, you're lucky you were moved here. Personally, I would have left you where you were, with your friends.
You can talk. I don't think much of your friends either. There's nothing as bad as a bent screw.
Hurry up, Dobbs.
Still, I suppose Terrible Terry's pretty much your style, I guess. I mean, after George Lucas.
Shut up.
Touched a sore point, didn't I? Don't worry, Vera, you can't help it if you're attracted to the criminal type.
Shut up, or I'll...
What'll you do? Throw me in the pound. I'll be no worse off there than I am here. The only way you're going to get rid of me is by organising that trip to Barnhurst.
It's not up to me, Gaffney. It's out of my hands.
All right. But you just wait till I get out of here. Your boyfriend's going to be out of Wentworth so fast he'll make Superman look like an old age pensioner.
Then we'll have to make sure you never get out, won't we?
Such a plain building. No design, no pride in building. Almost like Russia.
Hello, Bill. This is Anna Johansson. Mrs. Davidson's expecting us.
How do you do? Fine.
What is he doing now?
Just has to check with the governor before he lets us in. That's why I phoned earlier.
Do they trust you?
It's not that.
Oh. Do you have many escapings here?
Oh, few? Why?
The fences and what is this, sharp wire?
Well, it is a prison.
Ah, he is only dangerous criminal?
Oh, no, 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 they're all times.
Even first-time people?
Yes.
It would not happen in Sweden.
Oh, Mr. Fletcher, are you busy?
Well, I was due for an afternoon off, but if you require something urgently...
No, I'll... take a break. It's just that Mrs. Morris is bringing someone in to look around the prison, and I need a guide.
Oh, well...
No, really, it's my responsibility.
Ah, Mrs. Davidson. This is Anna Johansson. Erica Davidson, the governor of Wentworth.
So kind of you to let me look around.
Not at all. I hope we can show you something of interest. Oh, this is Jim Fletcher, our deputy governor.
How do you do?
You're from...
Sweden.
Sweden. Beautiful country.
Ah, you have been there?
Well, not exactly.
Unfortunately,
but...
you've caught me at a bad time. I would show you around myself, but I have some urgent reports to prepare with Mrs. Morris. I'll ring through and see if there's an officer.
No, it's all right, Mrs. Davidson. I'll show Miss Johansson through.
Oh, but you're busy, Mr.
Fletcher. No, it's quite okay, Miss Johansson. I'd just like to sign in. I'll show you through.
Well, I'll meet you back here in about an hour, Anna.
Oh, fine. You go on. Don't let me interrupt.
This way, Miss Johansson.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Poor Jim. Haven't the heart to tell him she's leaving tonight.
Oh, he'll find out soon enough. She seems rather pleasant. I look forward to talking to her later.
By the way, could you come and have dinner with us tomorrow night?
Oh, that would be rather nice. Actually, I'm going into the country tomorrow, but I should be back by the evening.
Oh?
Oh, it's just to see my mother. She's had another one of those relapses.
Oh, I'm sorry. Well, we'll expect you when you arrive.
Thank you. I shall look forward to it.
Look, I'm jack of this caper, B. Well, I'm running around looking for that tape you want. Some mongrel's come and pinched all my cassettes.
Take your recorder too?
Oh, no, just the tapes.
Don't worry, we'll get it back. You know, someone is going to have one hell of a time checking all those tapes.
They're probably starting up a disco in the staff room.
Woo! Can't you just see Vera in disco pants?
Ugh.
Yuck. Oh, here I go again.
What again?
Well, I'm crook, B, and when you got to go, you got to go.
Do you reckon she is sick?
Oh, I don't know.
And this is the laundry. This is
Woo!
The
oh, this.
All right, settle down. Ladies, this is Anna Johansson. She's from Sweden. She has an interest in Australian prisons.
Yeah, well, shame you didn't come early. You've missed feeding time.
Oh, you can still throw a few peanuts, eh?
I'm sorry, but this is me.
That's enough out of you. I think you've come here to stare at them.
Yeah, like in a zoo.
I said that's enough,
no,
Smith.
I can understand this. It is a natural feeling if you lock people in cages.
Well, there's a turn up for the books.
Here is a woman who really knows what she's talking about.
Miss Johansson has a connection with Swedish prisons.
Yeah, yeah. My brother has been trying for many years to change the attitude of the prison. He has studied all European system.
Well, tell him not to immigrate here because he'd be sadly disappointed.
Yeah, I think so. In Sweden, we try to change the social attitude too. Instead of trying to change criminal,
We try to take away the need for crime.
Oh, fat lot of good that'd do here.
Mm. Oh, I don't know. I read in the paper once that over there they have blokes and women in together.
Denmark. The only thing prisoners lose is their freedom. They do what they like in spare time. They work, get bed wages, get food from cafeteria.
Yeah, and they've even got co-ed dormitories.
What is a co-ed?
Men and women sharing a cell together.
It is only single cell. But visitors can come to prison at any time, except at night.
Oh, lead me to it. How do you get into a joint like that?
Same way we got in here.
Yeah, there is one thing. This is for first time prisoner only. If you get sent back to jail, then you go to Harper prison.
I knew there'd be a catch.
I'm sorry, Miss Johansson. We can't hold up the women's work
any
longer.
Oh, yes, of course. Sorry. Goodbye. It's good to talk with you.
Nice to meet you. Yeah, bye. Well, fancy that. Makes a bit of a difference to the usual snobs that come to see the poor, unfortunate prisoners.
It's a pity we can't use some of our ideas, huh?
Don't tell me you want a bloke in your cell.
Well, we could talk about a sister.
Hey, you reckon she's spoken to the governor?
I don't know why.
Well, she might have planted a few seeds for us. So, what do you think about the Needs Committee now?
Very kind of you to let me look around, Mrs. Davidson. I will talk to my brother, who will be most interested.
I hope so. I'm just sorry we couldn't spend more time together.
I do.
Could you sign the book on the way out, please, Mr. Johansson?
Oh, could we, Anna, please. Thank you for showing me around, Jim. I'm sorry I cannot accept your invitation.
I must go, Mr. Johansson. Have a good trip. And thank you for your ideas. I'm sure we'll be able to use them.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
I'll drop you at the office on my way back, Anna.
Oh, thank you for showing me around, Jim. It is very nice to meet you.
Come back to Australia soon, eh?
Oh, I think I may have to. So many things I have not had time to do.
See you later, Jim.
Yeah. Suppose you're going out with your boyfriend tomorrow night, huh?
Yes.
Yeah, that's what I figured.
Hey, B, I was thinking, how are we going to tackle Dave about this Swedish idea?
Oh, good. Give us a go. I haven't thought about it yet, have I? Truth, where have you been? I almost reported you as a missing person.
Me and Kath just went through the kitchen, Bee. Not a thing.
Well, that's bloody peculiar. Someone's holding out on us.
You reckon it's Terry?
Well, either Terry or Vera. They're like Tweedledum and Tweedledee these days.
Hey, listen, I wonder how Vera would go in a Swedish slammer.
You know, I have been thinking about what that bird said. Even if we could manage to buy our own food from the cafeteria, that'd be a start. Put a stop to that garbage we have to eat now.
Yeah, and Doreen wouldn't have to end up living in the loo.
She's still in there. Poor little beggar must be really crook. Better go and check on
her. What are you doing here, Smith? The bell hasn't gone yet.
Coronation, Mr. Harrison. What's your excuse? Drumming up business.
What's that supposed to mean?
I heard you'd opened the Wentworth bottle shop, you know, liquor at discount prices.
I suppose this conversation has some meaning to you.
Perfectly. In fact, we were thinking of having a party in the rec room later on. Thought you might like to lay on the booze, you know, a bottle of scotch, that sort of thing.
What makes you think that?
I don't know. Bit of gossip here, bit of gossip there. You know how it is.
No, you tell me.
Oh, it's amazing how these things get around. I wonder how these sort of rumours do get started, Mr. Harrison. Hey, I thought you'd gone to the loo.
I did, but I came back here.
Are you a crook?
No, I'm all right.
Do the screws know you're here?
No.
Oh, come on, with this Margo thing going on, the last thing you want to do is act suspiciously.
What do you mean?
If it is one of the screws, you can bet your life they're going to try and pin it on one of us.
I don't know anything about it.
I know you don't, but you don't want to give them an excuse to think you're up to something.
I'm sick.
Then bloody report sick and quit ducking off every 5 minutes. Come to the rec room?
No. I think I'll stay here for a while.
G'day, man. How's it going?
Not bad.
Aren't you off duty?
I was supposed to have the afternoon off, but I changed my mind.
I thought you were on the night shift.
Well, I couldn't have enjoyed my afternoon anymore. I volunteered to be a tourist guide.
Wait a minute. I've missed something here.
Well, I certainly did, mate. The most remarkable piece of Scandinavian skirt.
Aha, yes, I've heard about these Scandinavian birds. I take it you'll be flying high for the next couple of nights?
No, but she will be. All the way back to Hong Kong.
Oh, well, plenty more fish in the sea.
Yeah.
You off then?
Yeah, I thought I may as well get a couple of hours.
Can I hold you up a minute?
What kind of weight?
I'd rather you got it from me than someone else. Jim, what...
what Gaffney said about the scotch and the tape. Well, it wasn't all lies. I did bring the scotch in for her.
You what?
Jim, I was trying to cultivate her. Well, you said yourself it's good to have an inmate on side.
I also said provided there were no rules broken.
Well, what if it's to gain her confidence? I mean, there's got to be some leeway.
I don't consider smuggling grog to be bending the rules, Terry.
All right, all right. Perhaps I did go a bit too far.
Why the bloody hell didn't you tell me before?
Because I didn't want you to think I had anything to do with the bashing. Look, I was nowhere near her. I just wanted time to try and find the bottle. Obviously, whoever did bash her has taken it and hidden it.
Do you know something, Terry?
What?
You're a bloody idiot.
Yeah, I know, I'm stupid. Well, I suppose you've got to report me.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe if the bottle does turn up, there's nothing to prove that you brought it in. Now, I wouldn't do this for anyone else, Terry, but I know that you're straight. I just can't understand how you got in so far.
Me neither.
Now, if anything else shows up, I want to know about it straight away. Got it?
Yeah.
And for Pete's sake, stop trying to cultivate informers.
All right, mate.
Hi.
Oh, hello. It's dark in here. Is the light bulb blown?
No, I just thought it'd be more, you know, special.
Oh, very kind of you, Nick. We shouldn't have gone to so much trouble. I've got to work tonight.
Sit down. Dinner's ready. I've got a surprise for you.
Oh, wine? Oh, that's very extravagant.
That isn't the surprise. This is. You can open it, you know. It's engraved on the other side.
Nick, I can't accept this.
Why not? I didn't pinch it. I paid for it out of my wages.
I know that, Nick. But I'm worried that you've got the wrong idea of me.
Look, I don't think much of marriage anyway. I think it's good that you and Bob can play up whenever you want to.
I do not, and neither does Bob.
Oh, come off it. What about the sweetie slady? Anyway, I don't think any the less of you for what you said to me. Lots of women go for younger men.
Oh, Nick, it's not like that at all.
But you said you'd had a thing going with a younger man, you know, the doctor.
But that was years ago, before I even knew Bob.
You've been stringing me along all the time.
I haven't, Nick. I do like you, but not that way. You've made me realize how much I've missed by losing Marty.
Your bloody son? Oh, you think I'm just a kid?
Nick, I'm sorry.
Sorry? You can shove it. You've made me look a real idiot. You invite me in here, the old man gets me a job, all this. You can stick the whole bloody lot.
Nick!
Hey, Nick! Get Nick.
Sam, Nick, stop mucking around. Will you open the door, please? Thank you.
What do you want?
I need somewhere to crash.
Oh, did Mummy throw you out, little boy, or did you run
Shove away? Shove it, Sam. I'm not in the mood. I want my room back.
Shove it yourself, goody goody. Your room's gone. I needed somebody to pay the rent.
Well, whoever it is, we'll just have to move out.
Sure. You can tell him yourself. Hey, Bernie! Bernie, this is Nick. He used to have your room before he went to live with his probation officer. He's come back to chuck you out.
Thank you.
Wouldn't have thought that's your sort of music, Vera.
I wasn't expecting you back so soon.
No, obviously. What are you doing?
Well, I'm checking through these tapes.
Tapes? They belong to the prisoners?
Well, yes.
Where did you get them?
I took them from their cells. They have to be checked. If there's incriminating evidence against one of the officers, we have to know about it.
Look, Vera, Terry's already told me about the scotch. But surely he's not stupid enough to get himself on a tape recorder, is he? Is he? All right, Terry, come on, tell me all about it.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Jim, I should have told you.
Well, go on.
Well, Gaffney said she had some information for me, and the price was a bottle of scotch. Well, like a fool, I brought it in for her. Well, obviously, a deal like that has to be kept secret. I didn't know she had a tape recorder running.
And you were playing private detective, trying to find it for him.
The integrity of the officers must be maintained at all times.
Oh, come on, Vera. There's been a serious breach of regulations. I'm surprised you allowed yourself to get so involved.
Jim, it's not her fault.
I know that.
Yeah, well, the question is, where do we go from here, mate?
Buggered if I know, mate.
Doreen?
Before a screw comes. What's that, Doreen? Where'd you get hold of this stuff?
Oh, it's a fair cop, Your Honor, I admit it. I bashed Margo. I snuck up behind her and clobbered her with my little piece of wood. She's a rotten bitch.
Where's the rest of it?
What?
Come on, Doreen, the tape.
Oh, yeah, that stuff. Well, I got that right here, Your Honor. Oops. I didn't mean to nick it, but it was right there with the grog. Of course, I was going to give this to my good friend Lizzie, because she's fond of a drop, but it sort of disappeared. I must
well,
have had
Mr.
a mouthful
Harrison,
or two.
I think we got you well and truly
normally,
snookered.
But then I suppose it could have evaporated.
Come home.
Hello, darling.
Hey, that was a great job of PR you did on... What happened here?
It's Nick. I failed miserably, I'm afraid.
Are you all right?
He read a whole lot more into our relationship than I ever realized.
Oh, it's my stupid fault for inviting him to stay here. Where's he gone?
Oh, he stormed out.
He'll be back when he cools down.
Oh, maybe, if he doesn't do anything stupid.
Maggie's not a suicidal type. I think he's proved that.
No, I wasn't thinking of that. If he gets into trouble with the police, he'll go to prison. And I won't be able to help him then.
Same again, thanks.
You're right there.
I said same again!
All right, break it down.
What's wrong with serving me then? Isn't my money good enough?
Listen, I think you've had enough, don't you?
Are you chucking me out?
You stay as long as you like, I couldn't care less. But no more grog.
I ain't give a damn! You're all idiots! The lot of you, you're idiots!
All right, if you want the bums rush, you'll get them out. Come on, let's go!
You got no right to let me go!
I'll get you, you creep.
And your bloody mates!
Just go home and tell your mother she wants you.
I hate you, Meg. I hate you! I hate you all!